إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. My brothers and sisters in Islam, in few days, people, hearts, أفئدة من الناس will be flying, traveling, going to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, repeating the slogan of Hajj, At-Talbiyah, Labbayk Allahumma labbayk, Labbayk la sharika laka labbayk, إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك. O Allah, I'm responding to you. I'm saying, I heard and I obeyed, O Allah. You commanded me in the Quran to perform Hajj, and also in the tongue of your messenger to perform Hajj if I'm able to. And here I am, O Allah, coming to perform Hajj. I also heard the call that Ibrahim alayhi salam made a long time ago when he completed raising the foundation of the Kaaba. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded him to call upon people to come to perform Hajj. فَقَالَ يَا رَبِّ He said, Oh Allah, I'm in the desert. Who's going to hear me? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to him, just make the call and I will make people hear it. الأثر رواه ابن أبي حاتم سند صححه الحافظ ابن حجر في كتاب الحج من حديث ابن عباس رضي الله عنهما. Brothers and sisters in Islam, At-Talbiyah is the law of servitude, قانون العبودية, that must be also carried out throughout our lives. When there is a command, you say to it, لبيك اللهم لبيك. Pray five times, لبيك اللهم لبيك. Fast, لبيك اللهم لبيك. But it is so special for Hajj. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لما سئل عن أفضل الحج من حديث أبي بكر الصديق رضي الله عنه في سنن الإمام الترمذي قال أفضل الحج العج والثج والعج هو رفع الصوت بالتلبية والإهلال. العج that you raise your voice with التلبية والثج هو إراقة الدماء الهدي the sacrifice. وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم في الحديث الذي أخرجه الترمذي أيضا من حديث أبي العباس سهل بن سعد الساعدي رضي الله عنه ما من ملب يلبي إلا ولبى عن يمينه وعن يساره إلى أن تنتهي الأرض من حجر ومدر وشجر. Anyone who says لبيك اللهم لبيك, all the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, including trees, rocks, houses, homes, to his right and to his left, will utter the talbiyah with that person. Brothers and sisters in Islam, at-talbiyah was also a ritual that the messengers of Allah used to raise their voices with. Because again, it's the law of servitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أخرج الإمام مسلم في صحيحه من حديث ابن عباس رضي الله عنهما, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his companions were traveling from Medina to Mecca to perform Hajj, الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم asked, أي واد هذا؟ Which valley this is? قالوا وادي الأزرق. They said to him, this is the valley or the blue valley. فقال صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, وكأني أنظر إلى موسى عليه السلام, as if I'm seeing Musa عليه السلام, placing his two fingers in two ears, in his two ears, رافعا صوته بالتلبية, raising his voice with التلبية in his way to Mecca to perform Hajj. لبيك اللهم لبيك. Later on, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم asked, أي واد هذا؟ قالوا وادي هرشا. This is the valley of هرشا. قال وكأني أنظر إلى يونس بن متى, as if I'm looking at Yunus عليه السلام, riding his camel, holding the robe of his camel, and he is raising his voice with التلبية. وفي حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه في صحيح مسلم يقسم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم على هذا والذي نفسي بيده, by the one in whose hand my soul is, when Isa ibn Maryam عليه السلام descends to earth, لَيَهِلَّنَّ ابْنُ مَرْيَمَ بِفَجِّ الرَّوْحَى مُعْتَمِرًا أَوْ حَاجًّا أَوْ لَيُثَنِّيهَمَا. ابن مريم, يا أخي يعني ممكن تأخذه يعني برا, بارك الله فيك يعني. جزاك الله خيرا. عيسى ابن مريم عليه السلام will descend and he will do talbiyah and ihlal from Fajr al-Rawha. فالتلبية يا إخوة is a great act of the rituals of Hajj. Brothers and sisters in Islam, a lot of the people who go to Hajj, they don't know the story of the house, the house of Allah. And the knowledge of the story of the house of Allah is what gives the Hajj a spirit. The Hajj is not just stoning and walking and running and la. Hajj, there is a spirit for the pillar, brothers and sisters in Islam. In that short time, inshallah, I want to share with you some of that story. وهي مخرجة في صحيح البخاري من حديث ابن عباس رضي الله عنهما. قال الله تعالى, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ أَوَّلَ بَيْتٍ وُضِعَ لِلنَّاسِ لَلَّذِي بِبَكَّةَ مُبَارَكًا وَهُدًى لِلْعَالَمِينَ. Indeed, the first house that was placed, the scholars of tafsir said, the angels placed it, هذا قول. Adam عليه السلام placed it, هذا قول. Ibrahim عليه السلام placed it, هذا قول. ومنهم من جمع بين هذه الأقوال. And some of them who combined all of these. He said, first was put by the angels, then Adam rebuilt it, then Ibrahim عليه السلام rebuilt it. إن أول بيت وضع للناس للذي ببكة مباركة. وبكة هي مكة, وسميت ببكة because of reasons. Anyone who goes, tries to harm the sacred house of Allah and the people around it, بكه الله بكة, أي كسره, أي قصمه. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will destroy this person or will destroy this, those people. وما خبر أصحاب الفيل عنكم ببعيد. قال تعالى ألم ترى كيف فعل ربك بأصحاب الفيل. The people of the elephant, you know their story. وسميت ببكة because it's so crowded. وسميت ببكة because the people go there, they tear, asking the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the same verse, فِيهِ آيَاتٌ بَيِّنَاتٌ. In this house there are clear signs. وَهَذَا قَوْلٌ عَامٌ, لَفْظ عَامٌ. ثُمَّ خَصَّصْ. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala singled out from these clear signs one sign. مقام إبراهيم, the station of Ibrahim. The station of Ibrahim, ya ikhwa, is that golden thing that is near the Kaaba. It was originally attached to the Kaaba, but during the reign of Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu an, to ease it down on those who are doing tawaf, he moved it to the side. What is the story of this maqam? Ibrahim was born in Iraq, and then he went to Sham later on when his father and his people rejected him, and they actually tried to kill him by throwing him in the fire. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved him. He migrated to Sham, Palestine. حتى يقول لك هناك مدينة اسمها الخليل, مدينة الخليل, يسمونها هبرون, مدينة الخليل. طيب, what got Ibrahim into Mecca? Brothers and sisters in Islam, all what I'm about to share with you is in the Old Testament too. Subhanallah. Ibrahim and his wife Sarah, there was a drought in Palestine, so they went to a land called أرض الجبار. والحديث في صحيح الإمام البخاري من حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه. The land of the oppressor. Sarah was an extremely beautiful woman, and that was a wicked king who would grab the women and would forcefully raid them. His guards spotted Sarah رضي الله عنها. We could say وعليها السلام if we make sure that we know that women cannot be prophets and messengers. and he tried to rape her. Subhanallah, when they took her from her husband Ibrahim alayhi salam, fazi'a ila salah. Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam rushed to the salah, praying. Taban, a very difficult situation in a strange land, and they taking your wife away from you. Ma ghayr Allah, who else can help you? The king tried to attack Sarah. She made dua. Allahumma innaka ta'lam anni ahsantu farji ala zawji wa amantu bi rasulik. You know, O Allah, that I'm a chaste woman and I believe in your messenger Ibrahim alayhi salam. Protect me. The hand of that king got paralyzed. He begged her to call Abu Allah to cure him. She did. He tried again and again, three times. At the end, he let her go and he given her a gift, a maid. Her name is Hajar. And he given Ibrahim alayhi salam, and يعني في كتب أهل الكتاب يقول لك كان معهم سيدنا لوط, the provision that they needed, and they went back to Palestine. Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam was getting old. And Sarah was barren. No children. And she knew that he is so eager to have a child. Not just for the sake of having children, not to help him in the worldly things, not to inherit their wealth, not to carry on their names, no. To carry on teaching Tawheed, the deen of Allah, to the rest of humanity. She told him, go ahead and marry my maid so that you may have the child that you want. Multiple wives, ya ikhwa, ليست فقط من شريعة الإسلام. من شريعة الأنبياء السابقين, إبراهيم عليه السلام. He married Hajar, she conceived right away. And she delivered Ismail alayhi salam. When she delivered, Sarah started having feelings of jealousy. That's a natural thing for a woman. And it is the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah commanded Ibrahim alayhi salam to take Hajar and Ismail to the desert in Mecca, where the house of Allah is. He took them and he carried with him some dates and some water. موقف يا إخوة, out of this world. Someone takes his wife to a desert, placing her alone. Deserts, we're talking about snakes. Desert, we're talking about wind. Alone with her baby child. And leaving them with some dates. And leaving them with some water. That's it. That's it. Hajar, radiallahu anha, was so concerned with one thing. Is this a command from Allah or not? She asked Ibrahim alayhi salam at first, O Ibrahim, why are you doing this to us? Why are you doing this to us twice? The third time she said to him, Allahu amaraka bihada. Did Allah command you to do this? فَأَوْمَأَ بِرَأْسِهِ يعني نعم, yes. فَقَالَتْ اذْهَبْ إِذَنْ لَا يُضَيِّعُنَا. Out of this world, هذا اليقين في هذه المرأة التي هي أما, a slave woman, who was brought up as a slave in Egypt, in an environment of shirk, living with that wicked oppressor. Here she is, few years in the house of Imam al-Nas. وَإِذِ ابْتَلَى إِبْرَاهِيمَ رَبُّهُ بِكَلِمَاتٍ فَأَتَمَّهُنْ قَالَ إِنِّي جَاعِلُكَ لِلنَّاسِ إِمَامًا. Look what she developed. Yaqeen. Certainty. Muslims now are commanded not to own homes through riba. Command from Allah. They are afraid to be poor. They are afraid for tax returns. Where? أمرك الله بهذا لا يضيعنا. I live in a rental home, يا أخي. لا يضيعني ربي. لا يضيعني. يضع فلوسه في البنك. Places his money in the bank. Receives riba. عايز يبقى rich. أين? Where is the command of Allah? أين اليقين في الله? Where? لا يضيعنا. Muslim الآن go sells liquor. Liquor. لعن الله الخمر وحامله وشاربه وبائعه. Allah curses the one who sells it. يقول لك أنا ببيعها على الكافر. يا أخي رب العالمين حرمها للكافر ولا غير الكافر. فلوس يا عم الشيخ. يا عم the command from Allah لا يضيعنا. لا يضيعنا. هذه أمة. A slave woman. علمت البشرية اليقين بأمر الله. اليقين. Certainty. نعم تبتلى. Yes, you will be tested because you will follow the command of Allah. Yes, you will be tested. Yes, it will be hard. Yes. But be certain that Allah will never waste you. The water ran out. The dates ran out. ها هي تعلمنا شيئا آخر. She teaches us something else called التوكل على الله. The concept of reliance upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How is it? Yes, in her heart she knows that Allah will never waste her. Never waste her child. The baby who's crying from hunger. But yet, she knows that she has to seek the means. هذا هو التوكل. القلب, the heart, this limb, believes that Allah is the one who will send the help. But yet you have to seek the means. She started running between the two mountains. الصفا والمروة. وهذا هو السعي. كثير من المسلمين يذهب يمشي بين الصفا والمروة and he doesn't even reflect upon that story. Sometimes they take pictures. Brothers, take picture of me while I'm doing the سعي. يا الله. Reflect upon that woman. Woman running for her baby. Baby. حب الأب لابنه والأم لولدها حب فطري. The love that the parents have for the child is a love that they fashioned with. It's something natural. And her baby is crying, wanting to eat. She runs. Imagine, subhanAllah, now we walk between those two mountains, ceramic tile and air condition and fans. La, it was a desert. Sah, she goes to Safa. Sah, anybody, any hill. El Marwa, sah. Seven rounds. And at the end, Allah never wasted her. She saw Jibreel alayhi salam landing in earth. فسألها جبريل. Jibreel alayhi salam asked her, من أنت؟ هو يعرف. He knows. Who are you? وهذه الرواية في مع في 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 يعني عند الطبري ابن جرير علي بن أبي طالب is the narrator is an addition. Who are you? She said, أنا أم ولد إبراهيم. I am the mother of Ibrahim's son. شوف. Why did he leave you here? To Allah. فقال لها تَرَكَكُمَا لِكَافٍ أَلَيْسَ اللَّهُ بِكَافٍ عَبْدَهُ. He left you to somebody who, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who will take care of you. وَضَرَبَ. And he strike the earth with his wing. وَهَا هِيَ زَمْزَمْ. The will of Zamzam. Water, subhanAllah, that we still drink off until this very day. وقال عنها النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ماء زمزم لما شرب له ماء زمزم لما شرب له. حديث حسن في صحيح ابن حبان حديث جابر. Whatever intention you have when you drink the water of Zamzam, Allah will give you that intention. But don't test Allah. Don't try Allah. Don't say, okay, Allah, I'm going to try this. لا. You have to drink with certainty. Abdullah ibn al-Mubarak, rahimahullah, says, when he approaches the water of Zamzam, says, إِنِّي سَمِعْتُ أَبِي الزُّبَيْرِ عَنْ جَابِرِ ابْنِ عَبْدِ اللَّهِ يَقُولُ قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says ماء زمزم لما شرب له. The water of Zamzam is what is being drunk for. يا رب إني أشربها لأهوال يوم القيامة. Oh Allah, I'm drinking it so that I don't get thirsty in the day of resurrection. Brothers and sisters in Islam, amazing. The story in the Old Testament ends there. As if Ibrahim alayhi salam throwing his family in the desert and never cared less about them. When he is in his way, made that beautiful dua. رَبَّنَا إِنِّي أَسْكَنْتُ مِنْ دُرِّيَّتِي بِوَادٍ غَيْرِ ذِي زَرْعٍ عند بيتك المحرم. الآية. But the story in Hadith ibn Abbas continues that Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam kept shuttling between Mecca and Jerusalem. Mecca, Jerusalem. قيل أنه كان يركب البراق. It was said that he used to ride the animal, which is al-buraq, that the Prophet ﷺ rode in his journey from al-Isra, the journey of al-Isra and al-Mi'raj. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله. سيدنا إبراهيم عليه السلام in one journey after the death of Hajar, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded him to slay his son. Again, that's why Ibrahim is the imam of mankind. Because he never said anything but I hear and I obey to the command of Allah. Even once it comes to slaying your only son with your own hands. Labba. Yes, O Allah. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved him. فَلَمَّا أَسْلَمَا وَتَلَّهُ لِلْجَبِينَ وَنَادَيْنَاهُ أَنْ يَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ خَدْ صَدَّقْتَ الرُّؤْيَا. What is so amazing about this story, two brothers and sisters in Islam, is how Ibrahim alayhi salam brought up his son. How Ibrahim brought up his son. Ya Bunay, my son, إني أرى في المنام أني أذبحك. I saw in my dream that I am slaying you. Ismail يعلم. Ismail knows that رؤيا الأنبياء, the dreams of the prophets, وحي من الله. A revelation and commands from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look at the son. قال يا أبت افعل ما تؤمر ستجدني إن شاء الله من الصابرين. My father, do what Allah commanded you. Do. Another journey, brothers and sisters in Islam. Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam arrived. He entered the house of his son Ismail. فسأل عنه. He asked about him because he was not there. He asked his wife, where is Ismail? The wife answered by saying, خرج يعني يصطاد أو يقتاد لنا يعني. He went out. Sayyidina Ismail عليه السلام used to work as a hunter. He used to go to the desert and hunt. So he used to spend days outside the house. Sayyidina Ibrahim عليه السلام asked the wife a very interesting question. كيف عيشكما? How is your life? يعني how things going? قالت بشر. Awful. Terrible. كم من المسلمين يفعل ذلك الآن. أوف. تسأل المسلم كيف حالك يا أخي. Man, terrible. Things, the economy, the business is not doing well. It's terrible. هذا إنسان لا يشكر نعمة الله. لا يشكر نعمة الله. نبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول من أصبح آمنا في سربه معافا في جسده عنده قوت يومه فكأنما حيزت له الدنيا. Whosoever wakes up in the morning healthy, has the provision of the day, feeling secure, he's a king. سيدنا إبراهيم عليه السلام said to her, when your husband returns, she doesn't know that this is Ibrahim the father, tell him salam from me and ask him to change his doorstep. قولي له غير عتبة دارك غير عتبة دارك. Sayyidina Ismail عليه السلام returned. Somebody was here, yes. Who is he? I don't know, an old sheikh. He said salam to you and he said to change your doorsteps. He said, this is my father and he's asking me to divorce you. Go to your family. امرأة مثل هذه تجلب الخراب للبيت. A woman like this will bring disaster to the house. لا تشكر النعمة. تعطيها 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 ولا تشكر. Shopping, shopping, shopping. لا تشكر. لا هذه تخرب البيت. The following journey, شرحه. He entered into the house, a new wife. Where Ibrahim, where is Ismail? He went hunting. He asked her the same question. كيف عيشكما? قالت بخير. الحمد لله. الحمد لله. Everything is wonderful. Alhamdulillah. قال وما طعامكما? What do you eat? قالت اللحم والماء. We eat a lot of meat and we drink a lot of water. فدعا لهما إبراهيم عليه السلام قال اللهم بارك لهما في اللحم والماء. Oh Allah, bless their meat and bless their water. The last trip, brothers and sisters in Islam, that is compiled in Hadith Ibn Abbas is actually the trip when Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam arrived and he found his son next to the Kaaba, and he said to him, "My son, Allah has commanded me to raise the foundation of his house right here. Can you help me?" He said, "Yes, father, I will help you." And they raised the foundation of the Kaaba. وَإِذْ يَرْفَعُ إِبْرَاهِيمُ الْقَوَاعِدَ مِنَ الْبَيْتِ وَإِسْمَعِيلُ رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ رَبَّنَا وَجَعَلْنَا مُسْلِمَيْنِ لَكَ وَمِنْ ذُرِّيَّتِنَا أُمَّةً مُسْلِمَةً لَكَ وَأَرِنَا مَنَاسِكَنَا وَتُبْ عَلَيْنَا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ التَّوَّابُ الرَّحِيمُ. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam raised the foundation of the Kaaba as far as his hand reaches. But yet, he wanted to excel. So he asked his son Ismail to bring him a rock where he can stand on. He stood in that rock and his feet printed in it. وَهَذَا هُوَ مَقَامُ إِبْرَاهِيمُ. This is the station of Ibrahim alayhi salam. A symbol, shows you how this family excelled in serving Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Ibrahim, Sarah, Hajar, Ismail did so much for the deen. What did you do for the deen? What did you do for Islam? What? Ask yourselves this question. Are you going to leave something behind you? Brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewarded Ibrahim alayhi salam a reward that is out of this world. As we speak right now, Ibrahim alayhi salam is sitting and placing his back to the walls of the house of Allah in the seven heaven. Naam, Allah has a house also in the heavens. Hadith fi Ibn Abbas fi Sunan al-Bayhaqi bi sanadin sahih. Every single day, brothers and sisters in Islam, 70,000 angels go perform Hajj to the house of Allah. They never return to it until the day of resurrection. فإبراهيم عليه السلام is rewarded likewise. We are a community here in Colorado, in Denver. We are one family. We took on the task of putting together an Islamic school for the next generations, to produce the caliber of Ismail, to produce a generation like Ismail. Because I'm telling you, this is the only generation that Allah will empower on earth. People who say sami'na wa ata'na. Al-Ihsan Academy, brothers and sisters in Islam, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, on the 15th, not this Saturday, but the following Saturday, we're having a fundraising in order to move to the next step, the next phase, finding a location for that school. We need an Islamic school, underline the word Islamic, not 50-50, not 25%, an Islamic school that the community sponsors and takes care of in order to make a difference. In order to leave something behind us, brothers and sisters in Islam in Denver, we may not be here in 5, 10, 20 years, we'll be gone. But we got to leave something behind us. Our brothers today, inshallah, will be selling these tickets. Please mark your calendar. I would like to see all the community in that fundraising. Even if you're not going to give, but just come. Come Al-Ihsan Academy is the community project, is the future of this community. Help us out. Allahumma aghfir lana dunubana wa israfana fi amrina wa thabbit aqdamana wa ansurna ala al-qawm al-kafirin. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وأقم الصلاة.